5, 6, 7, 8.
That jazz.
that.
For her first number, Miss Roxy Hart would like to sing a song of love and devotion dedicated to her dear husband, Amos.
Sometimes I'm right, sometimes I'm wrong, but he doesn't care. He'll string along. He loves me so, that funny honey of mine. So I tell you that hole is a whole lot greater than the sum of his parts. And if you knew him like me, I know you'd agree. What if the world slandered my name? Why, he'd right there, taking the blame. He loves me so, and it all suits me fine. That funny, sunny, honey, honey of mine.
I mean, supposing he had violated her or something. You know what I mean? Violated?
I know what you mean.
Or something. Think how terrible that would have been. It's a good thing I got home from work on time. I'm telling you that.
He loves me so.
I say I'm telling you that.
Funny honey of mine.
Name of deceased Fred Casely.
Fred Casely? How could he be a burglar? My wife knows him. He sold us our furniture. He gave us 10% off.
Lord knows he ain't got the
told me he was a burglar.
You mean he was dead when you got home?
She had him covered in a sheet, and she's telling me some cock and bull story about this burglar and how I ought to say I did it because I was sure to get off. Help me, Amos, she says. It's my goddamn hour
now
of need.
Now he shut off his trap. I can't stand that sap. Look at him
it.
Go.
That cheap rat
on me.
She's
with just
me,
one
huh?
more brain. What a
now. She can swing
baby.
For all I care. Boy, I'm
if
down at the garage.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the keeper of the keys, the countess of the clink, the mistress of Murderer's Row, Matron Mama Morton.
Ask any of the chickies in my pen. They'll tell you I'm the biggest mother hen. I love them all and all of them love me. Because the system works, the system called reciprocity. Mama, Mama's good to you. There's a lot of favors I'm prepared to do. You do one for Mama, she'll do one for you. Tit for tat, and that's the way I live. So I deserve a lot of tat for what I've got to give. Don't you know that this hand washes that one too? When you're good to Mama, Mama's good to you. Gravy, pepper my ragu, spice it up for Mama, she'll get hot for you. When they pass that basket, folks contribute too. You put in for Mama, she'll put out for you. Folks atop the ladder are the ones the world adores. So boost me up my ladder, kid, and I'll boost you up yours. Let's all stroke together like the Princeton crew. When you're stroking Mama, Mama's stroking you. So what's the one conclusion I could bring this number to? When you're good to Mama, Mama's good to
Lipschitz.
And now, the six merry murderesses of the Cook County Jail in their rendition of The Cell Block Tango.
Lipschitz. So I said to him, I said, you pop that gum one more time. And he did. So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired two warning shots into his head.
He had it coming. He had it coming. He only had it.
Ezekiel Young from Salt Lake City about 2 years ago. and he told me he was single, and we hit it off right away. So we started living together. He'd go to work, he'd come home, I'd fix him a drink, we'd have dinner. And then I found out. Single, he told me. Single my ass. Not only was he married, oh no, he had 6 wives. One of those Mormons, you know? So that night when he came home from work, I fixed him his drink, as usual. You know, some guys just can't hold their arsenic.
He had it coming. He had it coming. He took a power and it was right. And then he used it. And he abused it. It was a murder as well of a heart.
Now I'm standing in the kitchen, carving up the chicken for dinner. Minding my own business, in storms my husband Wilbur in a jealous rage. You've been screwing the milkman, he says. He was crazy, and he kept on screaming, "You've been screwing the milkman!" And then he ran into my knife. He ran into my knife 10 times.
If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I bet you you would have done the same.
Meet Kira Shikeri. Ось мон якоє хірошло кумлефо к тому феріме. Ін ме глечіп тому феє. Та не ме гос. Ін арто тлом войок. Не тудом. Мерт моня анкл сам хок ін танцам. Пробол том. Аренда шенген мег моя разні. Ті намер татек мег.
Yeah, but did you do it?
Not guilty.
My sister Veronica and I had this double act, and my husband Charlie traveled around with us. Now, for the last number in our act, we did these 20 acrobatic tricks in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, splits, spread eagles, backflips, flip-flops, one right after the other. So this one night before the show, we're down at the Hotel Cicero, the three of us boozing, having a few laughs. And we ran out of ice, so I go out to get some. I come back. Open the door. And there's Veronica and Charlie doing number 17. The spread eagle. Well, I was in such a state of shock. I completely blacked out. I can't remember a thing. It wasn't until later, when I was washing the blood off my hands, I even knew they were dead.
They had it coming.
They had it coming.
Lipschitz more than I could possibly say. He was a real artistic guy, sensitive, a painter. But he was always trying to find himself. He'd go out every night looking for himself, and on the way, he found Ruth, Gladys, Rosemary, and Irving. I guess you could say we broke up because of artistic differences. He saw himself as alive, and I saw him dead.
A dirty bomb.
Number 17, the spread eagle.
Differences.
Pop.
Six. Squish. Cicero.
Lipschitz.
Give us in me.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the silver-tongued prince of the courtroom, the one, the only, Billy Flynn!
I don't care about expensive things. Cashmere coats, diamond rings don't mean a thing. All I care about is love. That's what I'm here for. I don't care for wearing silk cravats, ruby studs, satin spats don't mean a thing. All I care about is love. Give me two eyes of blue, softly saying, let me see her standing there. And honest mister, I'm a millionaire. For any fine attire Vanderbilt might admire, no, no, not me. All I care about is love. Your money, that's enough for me. I don't care for driving Packard cars or smoking long buck cigars. No, no, not me. All I care about is doing a guy in, who's picking on you, twisting the wrist that's turning the screw.
Mr. Billy Flynn in the press conference rag. Notice how his mouth never moves. Almost.
Where'd you come from?
Mississippi.
And your parents?
Very wealthy.
Where are they now?
6 feet under. But she was granted one more start, the convent of the Sacred Heart.
When'd you get here?
1920.
How old were you?
Don't remember.
Then what happened?
I met a Amos and he stole my heart away, convinced me to elope one day.
Oh, you poor dear, I can't believe what you've been through. A convent girl, a runaway marriage. Now tell us, Roxy, who's Fred Casely?
My ex-boyfriend.
Why'd you shoot him?
I was leaving.
Was he angry?
Like a madman. Still, I said, Fred, move along. She knew that she was doing wrong.
Then describe it.
He came toward me
with a pistol
from my bureau.
Did you fight him?
Like a tiger. He had strength and she had none, and yet we both reached for the gun. Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes, we both, oh, yes, we both, oh, yes, we both reached for the gun, the gun, the gun, the gun. Oh, yes, we both reached for the gun, for the gun.
Oh, yes, oh, yes.
Understandable, understandable. Yes, it's perfectly understandable. Comprehensible, comprehensible. Not a bit reprehensible. It's so defensible.
How you feeling?
Very frightened.
Are you sorry? Are you kidding?
What's your statement?
All I'd say is, though my choo-choo jump the track. I'd give my life to bring it back.
And
stay away from
what?
Jazz and liquor
and
the men who
what?
Play for fun.
What?
That's the thought that
yeah.
came upon me
when
we both reached for the gun.
Understandable, understandable.
Yes, it's perfectly understandable. Comprehensible, not a bit reprehensible. It's so defensible.
Oh yes, they both. Oh yes, they both. Oh yes, they both reached for.
Let me hear it.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Velma Kelly in an act of desperation.
My sister and I had an act that couldn't flop. My sister and I were headed straight for the top. My sister and I earned a vow, a week at least. Oh yeah. But my sister is now unfortunately deceased. I know it's sad, of course, but a fact is still a fact. And now all that remains is the remains of a perfect double act. Watch this. Now you have to imagine it with two people. It's swell with two people. First I,
then she.
Can't do it alone. Then she'd. Then I'd. Then we'd. But I can't do it alone. She'd say, what's your sister like? I'd say, ma'am. She'd say, you're the cat's meow. Then we'd wow the crowd. Then those ding-dong daddies started to roar. Whistles stopped, stamped on the floor. Yelling, screaming, begging for more. And we'd say, okay, fellas, keep your socks up, 'cause you ain't seen nothing yet. The second part is really nifty. Okay, she'd go. I'd go.
Shook his leg, you'd notice some. If someone in the movie show yelled, "Fire in the second row, this whole place is a powder keg," you'd notice some. And even without clucking like a hen, everyone gets noticed now and then. Unless, of course, that personage should be invisible, inconsequential, me. Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should I bend my my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. I tell you, Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me. Never know I'm there. Suppose you was a little cat residing in a person's flat who fed you fish and scratched your ears. You'd notice 'em. Suppose you was a woman wed, been sleeping in a double bed beside one man for 7 years. You'd notice him. A human being's made of more than air. With all that bulk, you're bound to see him there. Unless that human being next to you is unimpressive, undistinguished, you know who. Should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look right through me, walk right by me, and never know I'm there. I tell you, Cellophane, Mr. Cellophane, should have been my name, Mr. Cellophane, 'cause you can look taking up too much of your time.
Give them the old hocus pocus, bead and feather rum. How can they see with sequins in their eyes? What if your hinges all are rusting? What if, in fact, you're just disgusting? Razzle dazzle them, and they'll never catch wise. Vociferous, give them the old flim flam flummox, fool and fracture them. How can they hear the truth above the roar? Throw them a fake and off a niggle, they'll never know you're just a bagel. Razzle dazzle them, and they'll beg you for more. The days of old Methuselah, everyone loves the
when you're in trouble, go into your dance. Though you are stiffer than a girder, they'll let you get away
with murder.
Razzle dazzle them, and you got a romance. Talents, razzle dazzle them,
razzle dazzle them,
razzle dazzle them, and they'll make you a star.
Whatever happened to fair dealing and pure ethics and nice manners? Why is it everyone now is a pain in the ass? Whatever happened to class?
Class.
Whatever happened to please, may I, and yes, thank you? How charming. Now every son of a bitch is a snake in the grass. Whatever happened to class?
Class.
Oh, there ain't no gentlemen to open up the doors. There ain't no ladies now, there's only pigs and whores. And even kids will knock you down, so say and pass. Nobody's got no class. Whatever happened to old values
and fine morals
and good breeding? Now no one even says oops when they're passing their gas. Whatever happened to class? Your privates for a deuce.
And even kids will kick your shins and give
even
you
kids
sass.
Will kick your shins and give you sass.
Nobody's got no class.
All you read about today is a rape, a theft.
Jesus Christ, ain't there no decency left?
Nobody's got no class.
Every snot.
Every girl is a twat.
Holy shit.
Holy shit.
What a shame.
What a shame. What became of class?
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Roxy Hart says goodnight.
It's good, isn't it grand? Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it nowadays? There's men everywhere, jazz.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Chicago Theater is proud to announce a first. The first time anywhere there's been an act of this nature. Not only one little lady, but two. You've read about them in the papers, and now here they are, Chicago's own killer dillers, those scintillating sinners, Roxy Hart and Velma Kelly.
You can like the life you're living. You can live the life you like. You can even marry Harry, but mess around with Ike, and that's good. Isn't it grand? Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it? But nothing stays. In 50 years or so, it's gonna change, you know. But all is heaven. Now what days?
Okay, you babes of jazz, let's pick up the pace. Let's make the parties longer, let's make the skirts shorter. Let's all go to hell in a fast car and keep it hot. Thank you.
There's no doubt we're well cut out to run lies Yes, I'm here to testify. No, I gotta speak on my behalf. You don't even know what happened. Can I just tell you what happened?
He had it coming.
He had it coming.
He only had himself to blame. If you'd have seen it, I think that you would have done the same.
I mean, imagine, why was he hitting this woman? Why was she taking that? Now picture her fighting back. Think of the ass kicking. Think of his ass flipping down the stairs. And me at the top smiling. He should have stopped wilding. Now could you picture me trying to finish him off? See why? Me on the side of the law. High heels leave holes. You'd have thought I was gunning. Now the cops coming. I ain't running. Girl, you should have seen it. Should have bobbed and weaved it before the cops came. Got a couple of clean hits. In word to Jesus. Couldn't take the abuse, but I couldn't explain that to the state troops. But you know, girl.
Yeah, you go, girl.
Plus, I look real cute in orange jumpsuits. This is the story I'm telling, and I ain't changing nothing. I just needed you to know, Your Honor.
He had it coming.
He had it coming.
He only had himself to blame. If you'd have seen it, I think that you would have done the same. He had it coming.
He had it coming.
He only had himself to blame. If you'd have seen it, I think that you would have done the same.
Alright, alright, let's get this over with. Take the mugshot. Heavy up the fingerprint. Got the blood clot. Little Kim, a.k.a. Sophia Luciani. Keep your jumpsuit. I'm rocking the money. Yeah, I busted at him once, but that was just a warning. My lawyer be here with bail money in the morning. I'm not guilty. Just trying to protect mine. Ain't my fault he ran into my knife 20 times. Just my luck. The bastard ain't die. What you would've did if every other day he blacked your eye? Broke your nose till it started bleeding. Kick you in your ribs. Choke you till you stop breathing. That I'm sick of bobbing and weaving. Him threatening to kill me when I threaten to leave him. I do a bid, cause ain't no way gonna do me like Ike and OJ.
He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have seen it, I think that you would have done the same. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have seen it, I think that you would have done the same.
Mentally abused. How many of you been in my shoes before? Oh, have you felt you caught the worst case? Putting up with his tired ass in the first place? Why am I flipping? I just bought them condoms. I ain't used not one, but there was two missing. Here's a new mission, how to catch a cheater. If he only used coke, you shouldn't smell reefer. If you know he don't smoke, you shouldn't smell reefer. If you catch him cheating, you shouldn't yell either. Run up on him quietly, choke him out silently. Might sound cruel, but you gotta love the irony. So explain that. Just came back off a trip and I come home to this? Please, he ain't follow the guidelines. So forgive me, Your Honor, but he ran into my knife 5 times.
He only had himself to blame. If you'd have seen it, I think that you would have done the same. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have seen it, I think that you would have done the same. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have seen it, I think that you would have done the same. He had it coming.
But you can't take my love.